Welcome. In this explainer, we're going to break down a really powerful economic concept, but we're going to do it using a super simple, everyday example. Let's start with a question you've probably asked yourself at the grocery store. You know, you see the price of something, and it just feels random. But there's actually a clear economic logic at play, and together, we're going to figure it out. And to help us demystify these price changes, we're actually going to use a really straightforward method taught by economist Michael Revive. He breaks any price change down into simple, understandable steps. Okay, let's dive right in. So first things first, we need to understand the main tool that economists use for this kind of problem. It's called equilibrium analysis. And trust me, it's way less complicated than it sounds. Simply put, its entire job is to help us predict how a market's balancing point, you know, the price and the amount of stuff sold, is going to shift when something new happens. It really helps us see the cause and effect in the economy.
Now, what's really cool is that this powerful type of analysis actually boils down to a super simple, repeatable three-step process that really anyone can use.
Think of this three-step recipe as our guide. First, we just draw a picture of the starting point, the before snapshot. Second, we have to figure out who the event really impacts. Is it the people buying or the people selling? And third, we just draw that change to see the final result.
Okay, so theory is great, but let's put this method to the test. We're going to apply it directly to our tomato question and see exactly how it works.
All right, so here's our event, our big change. All of a sudden, it costs farmers more money to water their tomato plants. And of course, water is a key raw material for growing them.
So now we're at step two of our method. And you really have to think about this one. Does a higher water bill for the farmer change your desire to buy tomatoes? Probably not. But it absolutely changes the farmer's ability to produce them. The higher cost directly hits the producers, the sellers. So this is a change in supply.
We start with our before picture. As you can see on this graph, the market is in balance. The amount of tomatoes farmers are willing to sell at a certain price perfectly matches what we are willing to buy. We call this sweet spot, this equilibrium, point A. Okay, now for the change. Because it's more expensive to grow each and every tomato, farmers are going to supply fewer of them at any given price. So we show this on the graph by shifting that entire supply curve over to the left, which just means there's a decrease in supply.
And here it is, the after picture. Now, the demand from us to consumers, that hasn't changed at all, so our curve stays put. But it now intersects our new supply curve at a totally different spot. This gives us our new balancing point, point B.
So, what's the final result? What's the bottom line? Well, when we compare our starting point, A, to our new one, B, we can see exactly what happened. The new price, P1, is higher, and the quantity of tomatoes sold, Q1, is lower. And that's it. That is the economic story behind why your tomatoes got more expensive.
But, you know, this is about so much more than just tomatoes. What you have now is a reliable framework, a toolkit that you can use to analyze price changes for almost any product in any market.
So here's what you should really take away from all this. You can apply this method to anything, from gasoline to concert tickets. The most important step, the absolute key, is to first figure out whether the change impacts the buyer's side, that's demand, or the seller's side, that's supply. Once you know which curve to move, you can predict the outcome.
So the next time you see a price jump, or even a big sale at the store, try running it through this three-step toolkit. You might be really surprised by the economic story you can uncover just by asking a couple of simple questions.